watching the Kate Fox Show. I'm Kate Fox, and I am here with Robin Gilbert and Johnny Pags of Pagman and Robin. And we just saw you play a great set today. We're on the Nautical Mile.
Thank you.
And so first of all, you started out in a larger ensemble, correct?
Yes.
The Generators.
Yep.
And you have been, though, making the rounds as Pagman and Robin.
Yes.
For 2 years, I think, right?
2 years.
Has it been 2 years?
April 26th was our first
gig
2 years ago.
2019.
Well, that's good. Okay, great. And me too, I'm good.
It was at the Garden Grill in Smithtown, yes.
Yeah. What made you decide to downsize? And you were still playing in the big group.
Yeah, I wasn't used to downsize, but Johnny had the idea.
Yeah, it was just something I always wanted to do because I always played the bass with my left hand ever since I was a child. My mom used to yell at me, stop playing the bass, but I always used to love to play the bass. So I knew if I ever hooked up with a drummer, it would sound great because I'm playing the bass with my left hand, the piano with my right hand, and the drum. It just so happens to be it's a girl drummer, which even makes it even nicer. So,
and she's a great drummer.
Yes, she is. She's wonderful. Wonderful singer, wonderful drummer, and a wonderful person.
So you guys sort of said, and again, we are on the Nautical Mile, so you're going to hear some noise going by, so you know. So you said, hey, let's do this. And?
You know, we thought of the name. Well, I thought of the name, Pagman and Robin. It sounded so corny that people would remember.
Okay, and it's perfect.
And then it was Tuna's idea to throw in the Batman theme.
Yes.
Okay. And Tuna would be Charlie Saladino.
Yes.
My beloved friend and associate producer and special correspondent and photographer, because we have to give him all the...
Yes.
It was his idea.
Well, it was his idea to get more Batman-y.
It's stuck like people remember it now, the logo, everything. We have like it's all, it's a great gimmick, but it comes from our actual name. Well, that's the thing, so it's, you know, I said gimmick but it really works because that's who you guys are. I've been called Pags all my life, either Pag or Pags. Wow, how did that happen?
It's a good thing my mom didn't go with Rebecca, because that was the first choice.
Really, we would have had to come up with a different name.
Yeah.
No, that wouldn't have went.
That's my daughter.
Ah,
that's
I like
awesome.
That. What a vicious cycle this is.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. Pagman and Robin, I loved it right away.
At times it's tiring, but it's very, very rewarding. People seem to be loving us. We love to, you know, enjoy it with people, and they sing along with us. So it really is a give and take thing, you know.
Yeah. Well, first of all, people do love you, and you have people that follow you everywhere. Everywhere. I come and catch you guys when I can, you know. But it doesn't matter what town it's in. I see faces that I recognize.
Oh, wow.
And when I walked in today, I had a gentleman introduce himself and his wife to me Pagman Robin.
Oh, it must have been Mary Pat.
So, yeah. But it's, and I've had that happen before. And I've had a gentleman message me on Facebook. Oh, my wife and I, and this has happened a couple of times with different gentlemen. My wife and I are going to, are you going to be at this show? My wife and I are going to be here. We hope you, oh yeah. So, and I don't think I've ever told you that before.
No.
And so that's a huge testament to what you guys are doing.
We're super lucky.
Yeah, we are.
I just feel like it's just...
And everybody says the same thing. They love our songs.
We don't play heavy rock.
We don't play, loud music, loud rock. We try to play contemporary adult classic rock.
Just the time yoga stuff.
Yeah, well, that's what you do. And everything you do, though, is that you hit it out of the park.
Oh, well, thank
you're
you.
So
thank
sweet.
You.
Well, I don't lie. So we could be sitting here, I'd say, so how was your childhood?
It was rough.
we're going to take one break and we'll be right back.
Started out with a couple of live streams.
Yeah, the first one was actually my birthday because we were supposed to have a gig on my birthday, and I'm a big birthday person. I was so we just, I think people were like messaging us, like, is there anything you can do? We had seen a couple of live streams. We knew it was something we could do.
Right.
It wasn't super popular yet because this was March 22nd was my birthday, so it was early on.
Very early on. Yeah. Everything shut down March 15th.
Everything really shut down.
Yeah. Exactly. Okay. So we experimented down in the back cave, which is where we rehearsed.
The studio in Farmingdale.
The studio in Farmingdale, the back cave. And we sent out like an email with people being interested. Join us for Robin's birthday and we'll have a concert socially distanced safely. And so many people tuned in. We actually gained a large part of our fan base now because we did two more after that.
Yep.
One of our very dear friends, it's a couple, Bill and Linda Deegan. Hi, Bill and Linda. Linda was retiring and Bill was turning 65 and they were moving to Florida and they were going to come out for their final goodbye to see us. So we decided to give them a goodbye birthday retirement live stream and have everybody join in and wish them well. And that was in April. So we did March, April, I think just the two.
And we couldn't believe how many people tuned in.
They said they
were dancing in their living rooms.
Yeah.
And they were dancing in their kitchens and they left it on while they were cooking and
just
made us feel so
music.
Good. Yeah.
Yeah. It was awesome.
Yeah, it was awesome.
It allowed us to play because
we played. Yep. Nobody was hiring bands at the time. It was only solo and duo. So we were able to get exposure during that sad, sad time, but we were able to get out there and people were able to come out and watch us, and all the other bands were staying home.
So when you started the live stream, what was the reaction you got?
We had people, sending us messages and hearts and saying how much they loved it, and they were like asking for more. I mean, we played for what? For almost 3 hours. Almost 3 hours. And,
3 hours?
Yeah. Yeah.
And people could tune in or tune out, like they would come and go or whatever. Some people stayed the whole time.
And we could see who was tuning in, so we would say, hello, Bill, hello,
we
Jerry, hello, Mom. So we were actually communicating with them, so.
We wanted to be as close as like an actual, like another community experience, like it is live, as best as we could.
And I think they actually made some requests. They did some requests for them.
Really?
Yeah, so that helped. And then being able to get out there when nobody else could also helped us, you know. So, you know,
because that's part of you.
Right.
I mean, this is what you do.
Right.
Yeah. And it's that shared experience that everybody was missing, to see live music and to be able to play live music and have the whole, that's what it is for me, to this whole shared event with the energy from everybody that's around us, and then gives us energy. And the live stream, it was different, but we still had the communication. It was an open line, that communication with our friends and family and fans. Awesome.
Remember we hung the happy birthday sign?
We did, for Bill, right?
Yeah,
we
actually put balloons up and everything.
We had a cake for him. We sang happy birthday. We made a whole, just like they would have been there.
Right.
So, oh, that's great.
Yeah, it was awesome. And so many people know them, so they tuned in to wish them well. It was just awesome. It was really the only thing we could think of to do,
right.
You know, to play. And
it's funny, all the time, I would say 10 other bands, right after we did that, 10 other bands broke into duos. There were a bunch of stories. I mean, I go on and on and on. They all broke into duos.
Bunch of stories broke into duos?
Yeah. What's his name? Kenny did something with the another guitar player. Yeah, he was doing a lot of live
streams. It was like necessity because bands were not being
hired. Well, nobody. You had to be one or two. That was it.
One or two.
And you had to sit back and you couldn't. Yeah.
Right. No dancing. Everybody had masks on.
I've gotten in trouble for standing up at an outdoor show.
They actually had dance police. They had dance police on the floor.
But I mean, it's what it was. We all know what it was, and now it's fortunately better. But the live streams helped us.
And being able to get out there and play also helped us. And we've been so busy ever since then. And what's different about us is we're not just your normal duo. We're a duo that sounds like a band.
Oh, you do?
You know?
Yeah,
normally your duo is just a guitar player and a singer.
When you have a duo, there's never a drummer.
No. And it's a girl drummer, too. So that means we have male voice, we have female voice. We can do duets and harmonies, and it's just amazing how well it's worked out, you know.
Yeah. It is completely unique.
Yeah. And she's the show, you know, she's the Cher. I'm
the
Sonny.
Show.
You know.
She's adorable.
I know.
She's
everybody
got
loves
smile
Robin.
And
everybody
the
loves
and
Robin.
He's like playing everything. He's like playing all the parts, and I'm just like la la la.
Yes, yeah, so he's awesome. He's just like this, and you're like
It's hard for me to smile. I concentrate on what I'm doing.
So
she's like the smiling part of the duo, you know?
We both do our thing. You're not boring. But, you know, she's got the neon sign saying,
exactly.
I'm happy and I want to make you smile.
It's so much fun.
It's a lot of fun.
When I see people coming out, I just can't even believe that they're coming out. It's such an honor. I'm thrilled.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you, though. How does it feel now to be out again?
It feels awesome, especially now that people are allowed to dance. You know?
Yeah, that out again in
that normal energy, that whole shared energy that we all get to experience live. There's nothing like it.
And we prided ourselves on getting people to dance, and they couldn't dance the last 9-10 months. You know?
You've been live, but with people with faces, you can see their faces, and they can stand up and not get in trouble and move their bodies.
Yes. Very rewarding. Very rewarding.
We've all been waiting for 15 months. Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah. It makes us feel like we're doing what we want to do. We're hoping to accomplish what we want, which is to get people up and dancing and smiling and having a great time, forgetting about their worries.
When we see people having a good time, we end up having a good time.
Yeah,
so it's a give and take, you know. We make their night, they make our night, so it's roundabout, you know. It's very rewarding.
Well, that's what you're here to do, and it's great to see you guys continue to grow. Being able to do that again.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sorry, go ahead.
We feel very fortunate to be able to do this, you know, and, you know, because we're a duo, we're not really that expensive, so.
What we're going to do, we're gonna take one more break, and when we come back, we're going to do a little bit of a recap, and we're going to tell you where you can find them. Home of Tresses and Colors at 1227 Montauk Highway in Oakdale, and they are just preparing to celebrate 25 years in business and have recently won Best of Long Island. They are housed to Sunny and Dew as well, which is all natural skincare and hair products, and boy, you can find anything you want here. So don't forget to shop local discounts and mention the Kate Fox Show for 25% off any hair service. You're back out, you're playing, you got the gigs. What's coming up next?
Well, let me tell you. I've used that just so I could think, actually. We have Jesse's on the Water in Oceanside Friday night, 7 o'clock, and we have Otto's right here on the Nautical Mile Saturday night from 6 to 10. So we'll be in Nassau County next weekend. We really, every weekend right now, we're pretty much double booked. You can find us on our new website.
What is it?
It's www.pagmanandrobin.com.
Yes.
And we're also on Facebook.
Yes, facebook.com/pagmanandrobin. And everything's up there. You can find us, like our page. It makes me super happy when somebody likes our Facebook page. I love that.
Stop by the page and like it.
Yes, please.
And most of our gigs are going to be outside for the next couple of months. Otto's, exactly. Jesse's, Turning Point, Farmingdale. I mean, they're all going to be outside, so we get to breathe the fresh air and enjoy the weather, and it'll be as safe as possible, you know, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
Which, of course, when you're, So now, all right, are there any goals that you have not yet touched?
Should we tell them?
Sure.
Well, I've set this goal right from the start. Our goal is to play in Vegas. That's our goal. As ridiculous as it sounds.
What?
So we'd love
to
play
so
Vegas,
cool.
Disney World, something, at a Batman convention, whatever. You know, so that's our goals. That's our goals, you know, to get out there. Get out.
Hit the road.
Whether we can reach it or not, probably not, but it's something that we're going to set.
No,
you know?
I'm sorry, what?
It's something we're going to do.
No.
I got scared there for a second.
Fearless. Come on now, fearless.
Yes.
Okay.
And once you have the goal, you just go.
Fearless.
Oh, I thought you said feel this. like, what are you going to
feel? Oh, like, fearless, maybe yes. You'll get okay. The fearlessness.
Okay, you got it.
We don't get scared.
No, you're right.
We
no.
Set a goal
set
and we do it.
And you go for it, yes.
Yeah. Oh my, I like Vegas.
Oh, that would
I
be awesome.
I have ideas too that I'm going to talk to our friend Charlie about for you guys. And so, okay, is there something either or both of you would like to leave those who are watching? Is there something you would like to say about yourselves or some philosophy you would like people to know that you believe in? What do you got?
Well, I mean, Pagman Robin has just uplifted my social life. I mean, I get to meet all these different people. We get to play all these different songs. And it's just been a wonderful experience, especially dealing, you know, working with Robin. She's just a wonderful person, a pleasure to be with. And it's just been great. I never expected it to be this successful. And we're just going to ride the wave and see how far we can go with it.
What about you, little Miss Ballerina?
Well,
she is a professional ballerina too, for those that do not know that.
I'm sorry, I had to out you.
Thank you. You know, it's the same. Like, I love how easy this has been. Like, working together has just been literally like a dream and a pleasure. It's also so wonderful. And we have the same musical taste. I mean, just every song that actually. Pagman typically like brings songs. He listens to music all day at work, and I don't have that opportunity so much. So he always comes up with songs, and they're so great. So a lot of our song choices have been from him, which I love because they're always fantastic. I just am so happy with that.
Thanks to Pandora.
So, yeah,
I listen to it all day long.
It's
so
great. So just working together has been it's been
we have no
awesome. Okay. Oh, good, good, good. Yes, Pandora. Thank you. And, you know, just, I never saw myself singing so much and playing so much. And so for me, like artistically, as a performer, it's given me this, opened up this whole other dimension that I wouldn't have experienced without it just being a duo. In a band, with our band, we all sang, all four of us sang, which is amazing. I love that in groups, but as a duo, I hope I'm talking loud enough. I just got the evil eye. As a duo, for me personally, I just feel like I've grown as a musician. Like, as a dancer, that's been my whole life, but as a musician, it's been not so much my whole life. So I feel like I'm growing, and that's been personally very rewarding. And then as far as, like, being with everybody, which is what it's all about for me, I just love that we get to be with people and share music together and share, like I said before, an event that happens that makes you feel good. And if you were a part of making somebody feel good, I know that they make me feel good. So if I can reciprocate in any way, that's my goal.
And Robin does all the promoting. She does all the emails. She does all the Facebook ads. I mean, she really hustles during the week, and she gets it out
and
there.
I love
and
every minute.
Yes, yeah, well, most of the minutes.
Somebody has to do it, but thank you for saying that. Yeah, it's great. I mean, we work as a team. I feel like we're a total team. The duo is a true duo.
You're a dynamic duo.
We are
yes.
Dynamic.
Yes, we are.
But it's true. It's true, and I want to say thank you for talking to us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is awesome.
And we had a great time. I'm sorry about the acoustics.
It's all good. It makes the lively experience.
Right on. We are live. At the Nautical Mile. And just really check them out. Pagman and Robin.
Thank you to the Kate Fox Show. Kate Fox, we love you.
Yes, thank
and
you.
Charlie
for everything
Saladino.
For coming down. Thank you all of you
so
out there for making us enjoy what we do. We
yes.
really do. And we do it
we
for
love you.
You
guys.
And we're all in the same boat together. So
yes,
we love
absolutely.
It. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kate, so much.
Best. song ever written.